Welcome to Autofaze, I'm T. Bryn.
And I'm Tyler. Today we're going to be learning about color sanding
and polishing.
Down here we have our materials. Starting from the left to right, we have our sanding paper and dual action orbital sander from 1,000 grit up to 8,000 grit. Carry on over to the right a little bit, we have our polisher, the rotary polisher with our 1, 2, and 3 step. The first one is a wool with a more coarse compound, and you get more fine as you go. All the way off to the right over here, we have our dual action polisher, which kind of just vibrates while it spins, and it just makes sure to get all of the swirls left from the rotary out of the paint. The reason one would want to color sand and polish their car is to get this pesky texture out of your finish. Looks kind of like an orange peel, hence why it's called orange peel. So, I have already done it to the majority of this car once or twice since I've owned it. So today I'm gonna be starting with 1500 grit, work up to 3000, 5000, 8000, and then proceed with my rotary and dual action polisher. Here we go. All right, so for this demonstration, I'm just gonna do this small little area. So after you do your sandpaper, it'll kind of get a little flat, which is what you want. If you wipe it off, you'll kind of be able to see, I don't know if you can in the camera or not, but you'll be able to see what looks to be an orange peel. So you basically keep going until that is off of there. You step up grit. When you get to 3,000, 5,000, 8,000, you introduce water. Then it becomes more wet sanding than dry sanding that you have with the 1500. I have already thoroughly 1500, as you saw just a second ago. So now I got out my 3000, my water bottle. So I'll just get the paint a little wet and just proceed like I did. Now the rule of thumb is every step of grit you go up, double your time on how much you spend on the panel. So the reason somebody would color sand their car is to get out maybe bad car wash swirls, heavy contaminants. Instead of clay barring, you do this, you get out more of the impurities on the paint and in the paint itself, creating an overall better sheen. Here we are with our final step. We're onto the 8000. And again, just spend a little more time with this Trizac pad. You're less likely to burn through paint. Now, if you do go too far on your dry sand, you may burn through your paint, and that basically is eating through your clear coat. Don't do that. That's not good. So here we go. All right, now, as I said, don't be scared with the Trizac. You are still taking off clear coat, so by all means, be careful, but you're not eating through the clear coat quite like when you're dry sanding something. So Trizac is kind of like a first step to polish. All right, so we have moved on from sanding now to the rotary polisher. So when you do this, you don't want your speed too high because you are getting the paint hot. Again, with like burning through with color sand, you can burn through with this, but this is because of friction. Again, this compound also has a little bit of coarse grit in there, so that will help eat the paint off. But what you're doing is you're getting out all of your swirls that you put in there with the dual action sander. All right, so after you kind of have roughly polished it, you'll look at your paint and you'll see some little tiny, real tight, swirly scratches. That's from your dual action sander. So the point of the rotary is to get those out. So as you get it more and more polished, those swirls should start to go away and you'll have more of these straight line, longer scratches from the rotary. I want to get those scratches all the way out. The compound helps act as basically a lubricant too, so that way it helps keep heat from the panel as much as it can while aiding in it with the kind of grit.
When shops advertise paint correction, is that what we're doing here today?
Yes and no. A lot of detail shops don't take paint quite this far as to get the orange peel texture out of it. A lot of shops, if the paint is bad enough, they'll have different packages that you can purchase. Some will get the rotary out, but oftentimes you are using a one or two step dual action polisher process for paint correction.
So it's just polishing only, not color sanding?
Typically, yes.
Okay.
Some will go into it, but typically for a detail shop, it is mainly polish.
This light.
So you'll know you're done white padding or wool padding your section by your little small circular scratches being replaced with longer straight line scratches from your rotary polisher. So after that, you get your black pad out, you get your more fine compound, and you turn your speed down a little bit, and you go to town. Thank you. right, so your black pad doesn't take quite as much time and effort as your wool pad does, because you're trying to take out now similar scratches just with a finer pad and compound. So you go over it a few times, and as you see, when you get done and you wipe all your compound off, you're starting to have a near perfect reflection, making it a near perfect finish. Now, there is some risky business in color sanding and polishing a car. Like we talked about, you can burn through your paint. So I would always recommend hiring a professional, taking it somewhere to do this process for you. Now, if you really want to learn, I would recommend going to your local junkyard, picking up a couple of scrap pieces of, you know, say a fender or a hood, getting your polisher, going home and experimenting. You got to figure out what works for you. You got to figure out what doesn't. Just get the technique down. It'll all come together. So as you get done with your black polish, you move on to the blue. And as you see, every time it's a little less and less compound. Your compounds or polishes start to go further the less grit that they have in them, the more oils and greases that they will have in them. So, after you get done with your blue pad, you'll see that you do have a perfect finish. Now, a lot of people stop there, and that's perfectly all right to stop there. I have found for myself and my techniques that I like to go onto one more step, and that is with the dual action polisher, which you will see right now. I like to give my panel a good wipe down in between each compound or polishing step. I don't want any of the more coarse grit from my previous compound to affect what I'm doing with this compound. So with your dual action polisher, I like to prime my pad before I fully dive into polishing. You can see here that polishing can make quite the mess on your car. Now normally I like to tape off things like my belt moldings, my door handles. Sometimes I'll drape a blanket across one side of the car or the other, so that way there's less cleanup. This being my personal car, I have all the time in the world to clean this thing. So in priming the pad, I do a few drops of polish on it. I would put it on the panel, set it at a relatively low speed, and just hold it for a few seconds in the same spot, essentially. Now what you're doing to that pad is you're introducing a little bit of heat, so you're making it just a little softer, and you're lathering it up a little bit with the polish that you're going to use. So then I put just a couple more drops on the pad, and I am ready to go. Now, you may have noticed that I started to slow my movement down a little bit with this machine. The cool thing about the dual action polisher is
It's not polishing off of friction. It's polishing because of how the machine itself is designed. So, you're not going to worry about burning your clear coat with a dual action polisher because it's not heating it up quite like a rotary is. So if you're new to polishing, interested in polishing, don't know how, where to start, how you want to dive into, I would suggest starting with a dual action polisher. It's safe, you still get great results, you slow your process down a little bit so it takes a little bit longer, but you're not going to hurt your paint, and that's a bonus. And when you get done with that, you will see that your area that you polished is a perfect finish. Let me peel this tape for you so we can kind of see what it looks like around where I polished. Excuse my tape line in the middle, I'll have to come back and get that off. But you can see that the newly polished area is a deeper black than the previous area. We have a finished product, my one little section I was able to do today. Now, the difference may not be so dramatic for you viewers out there, but mind you, this car's already had this done once, maybe twice since I've owned it. If you have a car with a little older paint that maybe hasn't been taken care of, this is going to be a dramatic difference. I'm Tyler. Thanks for checking out Autofaze.
I'm Travis, behind the camera. We'll see you on the next one.